Yesterday, I got a $1,000 makeover at the Dior makeup counter, and today I'm going to recreate the routine using all drugstore products. If you're new here, hi, I'm Miranda. Welcome to my channel where we talk all things budget, beauty, fashion, and lifestyle. If that sounds interesting to you, then become the newest member of the Slashed Squad by hitting subscribe and the bell icon. I was invited by the Dillard's department store inside the fashion show mall here in Las Vegas to get this makeover from the Dior counter. Now, to be clear, it doesn't cost $1,000 to have the makeover done. It varies between stores, but on average, you only have to buy about 3 of their products to have your makeup done. But I totaled up the cost of all of the products the makeup artist put on my face. Everything cost $1,222. So I'm gonna share my Dior makeover experience while recreating the look using drugstore products. Let's get started. First, my makeup artist did a lot of skin prep with their own skincare line, starting with the Hydra Life Micellar Milk. As far as my go-to drugstore micellar water, I'm using the Simple Water Boost Micellar Water, which is specifically for dehydrated skin and leaves my face feeling super soft and fresh. It's obviously a thinner consistency than the micellar milk, but still very effective. Next, she moved on to serum, starting with the Multi Perfection Serum, which costs a whopping $170. It helps with radiance and skin tone, so for the drugstore version, I'm using my current Vitamin C Serum from Vichy. Layering another serum, this is the Skin Boosting Serum, which is one of their most popular products. It's a lightweight detoxifying and revitalizing serum, so I chose to use my Pixi Glow Tonic Serum, which exfoliates and boosts radiance, though it has a thicker, sort of tacky consistency. I always forget to apply eye cream before makeup. I do it at night, but not in the morning. So the one that she used on me was very thin and absorbed quickly, which I really liked. Similarly, my go-to right now is the Physician's Formula Rosé All Day to Night Eye Cream, which brightens and calms, but also has tightening agents. My makeup artist called the Hydra Life Fresh Hydration Sorbet Cream a gel moisturizer, which reminded me a lot of the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Water Gel. They both feel super light, refreshing, and hydrating. Next, she used the Dior Dream Skin Perfect Skin Creator as a primer. Now, y'all know I don't use primer often, but one drugstore primer I love is the Physician's Formula Spotlight Primer, which adds a glowing from within look while smoothing skin texture. The Perfect Skin Creator doesn't add the highlighting effect as the Spotlight one does, but this is what I had on hand. I was so excited to try the famous Air Flash Spray Foundation, which looked imperceptible on my skin. It barely looked like I was wearing any makeup at all, but it still added decent coverage. So I don't have anything like it in my collection, but I use the Physician's Formula Healthy Skin Foundation today since it has a natural finish with really great coverage. It's definitely heavier than the Air Flash, but it has the same very skin-like demi-matte finish. Dabbing a little bit of Dior lip glow on, this added moisture and a pink tint. So today I used the Pixi Shea Butter Lip Balm, which is actually slightly more pigmented and less glossy, but it provides the same effect. Under eye concealer time. So here she's using the Forever Undercover Concealer, and obviously I had to use the CoverGirl Undercover Concealer since they have the same name. Though the CoverGirl one has more of a dry finish and a thicker consistency, but I also felt like the CoverGirl had more coverage and less creasing a few hours into wear. So my makeup artist layered 2 blushes on me, not quite sure why because it was still a very light look, but the first one only added a bit of a glow. So from the drugstore, I'm using the Physician's Formula Butter Blush, which does the same thing on my skin, though I think the highlighting effect is actually more noticeable than the Dior. Then she went in with a more pigmented blush, but still very light-handed. This was a rosy shade with shimmer, so I pulled the Pixi Glow Cake in Pink Champagne, focusing on the color in the middle of the palette, still keeping it pretty light like she did, but I feel like I still ended up with more color on my face. Since I asked for the signature Dior holiday look, you know gold was gonna be involved, so she pulled the Liquid Mono Eyeshadow in Gold Twinkle, focusing it at the base of my lid and brushing upward. Today I'm using the Systar Cosmetics Glow Glitter Eyeshadow, which can be found in beauty supply stores for under $10. The Dior one was a bit more metallic looking in my opinion though. Then she used the gold shade in the new limited edition Happy 2020 palette and packed that onto my lid for more gold impact. I didn't want to pull a whole palette just for one shade, so I used the AOA Studio highlighter in Sunstone for this, which gave me pretty similar results. So you'll see my makeup artist kind of jumped around from step to step. It was a bit odd to me, but we'll roll with it. So next she took a break from the eyes and did my brows, which I actually love how these came out, but she could have used a slightly darker shade on me. So today I'm using the similarly fine tipped Revolution Pro brow pencil that's a better match for my coloring. And now back to the eyes. She used a very light bronzer in my crease to add subtle dimension. The entire eye look still had a shimmery effect though, because she brought that gold practically all the way up to the brow bone. So I'm gonna use the e.l.f. Contour palette to achieve the same look. Then she highlighted the brow bone using the champagne shade from the Happy 2020 palette, and I'm using the highlight shade from the same e.l.f. Contour palette. And I will say again, the Dior shadow does give a bit more of a reflective metallic look. All right, so my least favorite part of the makeover was how my lashes ended up looking, and it only fuels my stance on only buying drugstore mascara. So she started off by using a lash primer. I expected really pumped up results, but I didn't really see it doing anything. A drugstore primer I love, and I think works better than Dior, is the CoverGirl Lash Blast Amplify Primer. Next, she used a pretty cool mascara that had a squeezable tube, which allows you to pump up the product from the bottom so you don't waste any, but that's the end of what I liked about it, because it didn't really add much to my lashes. She also hadn't curled them, so they kind of look droopy and thick. Today I'm going to use the Believe Beauty Voluminize mascara. I think it makes a way bigger impact on my eyes. As far as highlight goes, again, she went really light with it using the Backstage Glow Face Palette. Y'all know I love a beaming highlight, so I'm using one of the more natural ones in my collection to mimic the look, the Essence Pure Nude Sunlighter. She layered a few products on for the final lip look, starting with this sheer rosy lipstick, and she went for a blurred lip line look, which was very different than what I'm used to. I'm using the Honest Beauty Lip Crayon, which I had to apply then smudge with my fingers since it was more pigmented than the Dior lipstick. Next up, I have a dupe alert here. Even though most of the products I'm using on the drugstore side are not dupes, this one is. So the Dior Fix It Concealer is a twist-up stick that has a hyaluronic acid core running through the center, exactly like the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Hydrating Concealer. Good coverage, also moisturizing. She applied it around my nose and my upper lip area to clean up the lipstick. On top of my lips, she used the Dior Addict Lip Maximizer, which is a plumper. I don't have a lip plumper, so I just layered a gloss in the middle of my lips for that pouty effect. I honestly think this many layers of product on my lips made them feel sort of goopy, so I would have skipped either the balm or the sheer lipstick because they kind of just added the same effect. She set my makeup with the Dior Skin Forever Never Powder, and today I used the Coty Airspun, which is my favorite right now. I will admit though, the Coty powder mattified today's look much more than the Dior powder, which maintained my skin finish. Technically after the powder, we were done, but I asked my makeup artist if she could add just a little contour to my face because I'm just not used to seeing myself without it when I have makeup on. So she used the same bronzer that she had added to my eyes onto my cheeks and my forehead, and I'm using the same e.l.f. palette on the drugstore side. So here are the finished looks side by side. I'm really curious to hear whether you have a preference between the two or not. Now, something that I didn't know about the Dior brand before going in for this makeover is that in terms of beauty, their trademark is very natural, understated makeup. They're more about enhancing what you already have versus changing or adding anything. And the way my makeup artist put it was they want people to compliment you and your beauty versus complimenting your makeup. Something I think I'm gonna take from the Dior makeover and incorporate into my actual routine is all of the skin prep. Usually before makeup, I'll do toner, vitamin C, and moisturizer, but these extra steps seriously made a difference. Just looking at my skin, it looks flawless. There are no pores visible. My skin looks smooth, the texture looks good, it looks plump. I will also give it to Dior for their skincare. I mean, it's expensive, but it felt really great on my skin, and I feel like the Dior skincare skincare felt lighter and fresher than the combination of products that I did use today from the drugstore. I'll be honest. But you would never in a million years catch me paying that much for skincare products. That's just me. And just in case you were curious, all of the products that I used today on the drugstore version of this look totaled up to $216. So about $1,000 less. In case you didn't know, we have a Facebook group called Drugstore Beauty Groupies. I'm always in there chatting with you all and answering any questions. So I will leave the link below if you want to join. Today's shout out goes to Ashley. Thanks for being a member of the Slashed Squad. And join me over in this video next where I do an eye look full of drugstore dupes for high-end products. I'll see you over there. Bye.